Hi friends, welcome back all. Very, very good evening to us in this video. Yes, I think I have covered about many times about a particular share, I think Rishi Roop Limited. But I think first time I want to say in YouTube videos, rather I covered it many times in my Telegram channel, right? So basically in this video, we're going to see about three things. Why Rishi Roop, business of Rishi Roop Limited. And the third thing is that what is the future for this company, right? And before starting this video, friends, if you're new to this channel, then make sure you can hit the subscribe button so that I could be able to provide you many more videos in the day coming by, and I hope so to do the same, right? And if you're already a shareholder of Rishi Roop Limited, or if you are going to buy this company, I just want to share you one of the important details. Kindly go and read their annual report, and basically the company's balance sheet as well as their cash and cash equivalents. Once if you are going to see the cash and cash equivalents of Rishi Roop Limited, and when you are going to compare with the market capital, you will feel, or you will come to say that, oh my god, such an undervalued company. Why such undervaluation? That is the word that people could give, because that is the kind of performance and that is the kind of thing that Rishi Roop has been doing for this almost the last 1 year. When we started the Rishi Roop coverage at maybe at 100 rupees or 100, or let us take at 120 rupees also, right? I mean, on a market capital basis, it could be around 120 crores, right? And after being silent for almost 6 or 5 months, the company did a superb and beautiful thing. The company bought back shares. Okay, I mean, the company buy back the shares in the open market at a price of 125. And the second thing what the company is doing each and every year, if you can go and see the corporate actions, the company is solidly paying 1 rupees as an interim dividend and final dividend as 5 rupees or 6 rupees or 1 rupees. I think these kind of dividends keep on increasing. And coming to the financial performance of this company, I mean, basically is due to the merger between two companies, this financials also go on increasing. And don't ask why the profit is 26 crores here and why the profit is just 8 crores here. The basic reason is because of the extraordinary items the company posted previous year. But leaving those facts, with a solid performance on a company side basis, as well as if we're going to see the cash and cash equivalents and their investments in mutual funds and cash and other instruments, right? That is going to say you an important thing. The company is paying good dividend. The company is having a good business background. Basically, the company is in the field of chemical sector, right? And that is a shining industry according to many investors in the market. And according to me, I believe that that industry could also shine a lot. But the main focus here is that even after this rise of, I think, almost 30% in 2 days, the kind of valuation the company is getting is very less. And as I already said, I really expect a valuation of anywhere between 220 crores to 300 crores. The basic reason of 300 crores, because I have a company which is having less debt. I have a company in which promoter is holding maximum promoter holding of 75%. I'm having a company where the company has the big stand capability to have the cash and cash equivalents, and I also have a company of having a good corporate governance, and above all that, I am having a beautiful opportunity to make money in Rishi Roop Limited. And this is one of the few companies which go unnoticed. Maybe I still feel what has made the company to suddenly shoot up in the market in the last 2 days, also trying my best to get out the knowledge. But keep on seeing the same thing. Even after this almost 30% rise, the company is still undervalued, and there is many more days to go ahead, right? And if the company could be able to build on their business wise also, it could even more add fuel to the fire. And if you are going to ask me whether 200 to 300 rupees is justified for the company, based upon the past financial performance and based upon the current valuation, what the company is having as a balance sheet, okay? And during the buyback, what they did, which has also reduced the existing outstanding shares. Remember that also, right? Putting all these factors together, even after raising 200 to 300 crores of market capital, this company would be an undervalued company according to me. Thank you, friends. Let us see what's going to happen. I am very, very curious on this company. Now, the final question you could ask me, okay, you're saying the company is good, and many of my friends could have bought at area levels, but if you're not at end, what is the best option could you do? I mean, the best option is that, for an example, if you're planning to buy 100 shares, I would start to initiate my purchase at maybe at a partial rate, like 20 shares, 20 shares, 20 shares. I will not go in all in otherwise I will not buy even less shares. I will buy partially and cover up as the day is going by so that I could able to get a beautiful return the day is going by. Thank you friends and bye.